Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and today I'm going to show you how to use the Hellfire missile in the Apache as an air-to-air missile. Yeah, I know that sounds a little bit weird, but it is doable under certain circumstances, which we're going to discuss right after we do this. I just don't want to lose my target, so I'm going to go ahead and bring up the George helper menu. Helper switch right to have George WAZ the Hellfires. And he should be somewhere over here.
Slaving. Blazing.
Yep, got him. There is the Mi-26. We can see him there on the TAD screen. And I'm gonna tell George to fire. Okay, so my head tracker got a little bit weird there. Splash. Okay, and here's the first problem with doing this.
Engaging.
Let's give him another one, because that one did not kill that Mi-26. The Mi-26 is a big helicopter. Oops. Splashed him again. And that time he is going down. I think. No, maybe not.
Roger, engaging.
Let's give him one more. The heat warheads on these Hellfires are fantastic for defeating armor, but it's a shaped charge warhead, so it only goes in one direction, which means you have to physically hit the target in order for it to do damage. It doesn't proximity fuse like a regular air-to-air missile. Let's give him another one here. Splashed him of. I think we're up to, what, three times now? That we splashed and four missiles fired? And he's on fire by the looks of things. Yeah, there he is.
Engaging.
I'm gonna give him yet another one. Okay, that one's a miss.
Roger, engaging. Roger, engaging.
Oh, there's another hit, and hopefully this one's gonna bring him down.
Roger, engaging.
It had better, because if it doesn't, I'm gonna have to WAZ the gun here. But, look at that. We've hit him, I believe, four times now, and we still have not brought it down. Now, granted, this is not going to be something that you would typically see, because the Mi-26 is a much bigger helicopter than most. But, still, just the fact that he's still flying here shows how it's something that, just because you can do it, doesn't mean it's a good idea.
Lasers off.
Oh!
Good effects on target.
Finally! That was a really close one. I didn't really expect George to fire that one, but that was, what, five hits? And that's all because of the, warhead on the Hellfire not being very big and being optimized for destroying ground vehicles. But the two other main limitations of the Hellfire as an air-to-air missile are, first of all, obviously the laser guidance, because the Hellfire is a laser-guided missile at the end of the day, the version of it that we have, and it just doesn't do very well when it's tracking fast-moving targets. You can shoot down fixed-wing aircraft with this thing sometimes. I've tried it, but it's not something you want to rely on, because I would say you have maybe one chance in four of nailing even a moderately fast-moving fixed-wing aircraft like an Su-25. And even if you do hit it, there's no guarantee that you'll kill it. An Su-25 might take as many Hellfires to bring down as the MI-26 that we kept pouring Hellfires into just now. Let's actually have a look and see just how many we had to fire. Had a full load of 16, and now we are down to... Well, that's 4 gone there and 3 gone there. That was 7 Hellfires we fired, and of those 7, I believe it took 5 of them to finally bring that MI-26 down. That was insane. So unless you get lucky with where the Hellfire hits, it's not guaranteed to one-shot anything in the air. But the other big reason that the Hellfire doesn't make a great air-to-air weapon is the fact that it's slow by air-to-air missile standards. The Hellfire only has a top speed of, I think, Mach 1.3-ish, and its motor burns out really, really quickly, so it only reaches that speed for about 2 to 3 seconds, and then it rapidly decelerates below Mach 1, at which point it basically has no energy to go chasing after things like fast-moving aircraft. So that is another very, very good reason to just avoid this kind of thing unless you have to. I really wish that we would get AIM-92 Stingers on the Apache. I don't know why we don't seem to be getting them. Obviously, they're not a feature on the Apache now, and from what I hear, they won't be. I don't know that I agree with that, but that's really what you would want to use in real life if you had to deal with an aerial threat in something like the Apache. And failing that, well, we have the other way of dealing with it, which is, of course, the M230 chain gun that I have wazzed right here now. But this is something that it's an interesting capability. It's just not an easy thing to do to actually use it in such a way that it will work for you. So I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial and my little spiel about why this isn't a great idea, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.